Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last several lectures, we studied systems of two linear equations and two variables, and saw how these systems could be represented graphically as lines in the Cartesian plane. Systems of equations can consist of more than two equations, and the equations in the system can contain more than two variables. In this lecture, we will introduce systems of three linear equations in three variables and see how they can be visualized in three-dimensional Cartesian space. The standard form of a linear equation in x and y is written as ax plus by equals c, where a, b, and c are constants, and at least one of the coefficients, a or b, must be non-zero. The term linear reflects the fact that the graph of an equation of this form will be a straight line in the xy plane. Just as the standard form linear equation in two variables x and y is written as ax plus by equals c, a standard form linear equation in three variables x, y, and z is written as ax plus by plus cz equals d, where at least one of the coefficients, a, b, or c, must be non-zero. Since the equation contains three variables, it must be graphed using a three-dimensional coordinate system, as we saw in the lecture, Cartesian coordinates in three dimensions. So what does the graph of a linear equation in three variables look like? Let's start by looking at some simple examples in two variables, and then extend the examples to three variables. When a linear equation is written in standard form, setting the coefficient of any variable to zero causes the term containing that variable to disappear. Even though that variable is no longer included in the equation, it is understood that the variable still exists and is free to take on any value. This is why in a standard form linear equation, A and B cannot both be zero, since this would eliminate both variables from the equation. If in fact the constant C was zero, then X and Y could take on any value and the statement would still be true. The solution set would therefore contain every possible combination of X and Y. And if the constant C was not zero, then no values of X and Y would make the statement true, and the solution set would therefore be the empty set. Since in either case, the graph of the solution set would not be a line, the equation 0 equals C cannot be a linear equation. So let's create a simple linear equation in X and Y by setting A to 0 and B to 1. This eliminates X from the equation. If we set the constant C to 3, we get the linear equation y equals 3. Since the values of x are no longer constrained by the equation, x is free to take on any value. The graph of this equation therefore consists of every point whose y-coordinate is 3 and x-coordinate is any real number. The set of all these points is a horizontal line 3 units above the origin. Likewise, setting B to 0 and A to 1 eliminates Y from the equation. If once again we set C to 3, we get the linear equation X equals 3. Now, since Y is free to take on any value, the graph of this equation consists of every point whose X-coordinate is 3 and Y-coordinate is any real number. The graph of this equation is therefore a vertical line 3 units to the right of the origin. Now let's try the same thing for a linear equation in three variables, setting the coefficients of all but one of the variables to 0. Let's start by setting A and B to 0 and C to 1. This eliminates all the variables but Z. If we set the value of D to 3, we get the linear equation Z equals 3. Since both X and Y are free to take on any value, the graph of this equation consists of every point in three-dimensional space whose z-coordinate is 3, and x and y-coordinates are any real number. The graph of this equation is therefore a horizontal plane, 3 units above the origin. If we set A and C to 0 and B to 1, all variables but Y are eliminated from the equation. And setting D to 3, we get the equation Y equals 3. Now, since X and Z are free to take on any value, the graph of this equation consists of every point whose Y coordinate is 3. The graph of this equation is therefore a vertical plane, 3 units to the right of the origin. Likewise, if we set A, B, C, and D to 1, 0, 0, and 3, all variables but X are eliminated, giving us a graph which consists of all points with an X coordinate of 3. The graph of this equation is a vertical plane, 3 units in front of the origin. Now, what do you suppose would happen if we set the coefficient of only one of the three variables to 0? For example, let's set the z coefficient to 0 and the x and y coefficients to 1. This eliminates z from the equation, but leaves the variables x and y. Now, if we set the value of d to 3, we get the linear equation x plus y equals 3. Let's ignore z for the moment and plot this equation on the xy plane. This gives us a line which intersects the x and y axes. Every point on this line is a solution to the equation x plus y equals 3, where the z-coordinate of every point is 0. But there are more solutions than this. All points on any line where x plus y equals 3 are solutions to this equation, regardless of the value of z. There are an infinite number of lines like this, one line for every possible value of z. Since z can be any real number, all these lines together create a plane. Each point in this plane corresponds to a solution of the linear equation x plus y equals 3. The graph of a linear equation in three variables will always be a plane when graphed in Cartesian coordinates, assuming that the constants a, b, and c are not all 0. Any plane which corresponds to the solutions extends infinitely in all directions. Depending upon the values of A, B, C, and D, the plane may lie in any position and orientation. We have seen that systems of two linear equations in two variables can be represented graphically as lines in the Cartesian plane, and the solutions of these systems correspond to the points where the lines intersect. In systems of three linear equations in three variables, the equations are represented as planes in Cartesian space. Each plane may be oriented at any angle and positioned anywhere in space relative to the other planes. Since each plane graphically represents the set of solutions to one of the three equations, the points where all three planes simultaneously intersect correspond to the solutions which simultaneously satisfy all three equations. These points, therefore, correspond to the solutions of the system. In the next lecture, we will look at different ways in which three planes can intersect in three-dimensional space, and thus different types of solutions which can exist for a system of three linear equations in three variables.